We are in position to be transitioned.
Amen.
That's a word, right?
Someone said we are in position to be transitioned. When you're transitioning, you're moving from one place to another. Nothing that's in transition is stagnated. I said nothing that's in transition is stagnated. When something is stagnated, it's showing no signs of activities. Let me say that again. When something is stagnated, it's showing no signs of activity. When people are stagnated, they're not moving. You can be in a moving ministry but not moving. See, the Lord can move, but don't mean you're caught up in the move. Come on, somebody. Amen, somebody. So transition is a choice.
Yes, it is.
You can choose to transition, or you can choose to stay stagnant. Somebody say, I refuse to do that.
I refuse to do that.
It's a choice, say. Everything in life is based on choice. You can choose to receive the more of God, or you can choose to be complacent and comfortable where you at. But somebody say, I refuse to do that, man. Heaven has so much for me to, amen, to offer, but you got to be willing to get it. Am I right? So you got to be willing to make sacrifice. If you're going to be in ministry, ministry is about sacrifice. Amen. The anointing is about sacrifice. Breaking before God is about sacrifice. And y'all ain't helping me up in it. You cannot receive the fullness of God when you ain't willing to put something in God. And one of the things that I've noticed, amen, everywhere I go is that people are not connected with God. So you can be in a place, but don't mean you're connected with God. And what we want to establish, amen, is that people understand what it means to connect with God. And what it means to have a relationship with God. See, you can't have no powerful, strong relationship with nobody if you never communicate.
All right.
Because the people got to understand, it ain't got nothing to do with no man.
Yes.
Let me hear this again.
Come on.
When you come to church, you never come based on a human being. Because a human being should never have more influence than the God you say you serve. That's simply to me, amen. I don't care who the Holy Ghost is on. I'm still going to hear that. I got to say that because we have been accustomed for so long. Amen. I got to come here. He's the only one that got the word. The devil is a lie. The Lord don't give one man everything. Y'all ain't helping me up in here. He don't give one woman everything. There's a team of ministry gifts that God will place in the midst of the people. And God don't want you to hear the man. He wants you to hear the spirit. And when I say man, I ain't talking about gender. Come on, somebody. You need to get the Holy Ghost that's speaking to the vessel. We got too many people, amen, that's caught up in people. And we have seen man to God. Y'all ain't helping me up in here. And see, the man didn't die for you, Jesus did. So God highly exalted him and gave him a name above every name. He didn't give a man a name. God is exalted him. And I think the problem we have with men is we so locked up into a man. And we ain't locked into God. If the man don't come to church, you won't even come to church. Y'all ain't helping me up in here today. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah to God. Your walk will never be predicated on an individual. Because we have put pictures up and we have put them up as God. Y'all ain't helping me up in here. He's a human being too. He's capable of making mistakes. He's capable of doing something too. Come on, somebody. He's not above mistakes. Y'all ain't helping me up in here today. Because some people can't even go on in God as a preacher follower. They can't even continue. The devil is alive. I still can praise God. But my pastor backslide today and get drunk. It ain't the end of the world for me. The devil's alive. I ain't about to leave no church. Because my relationship with my predicator on him. It was predicated on God. And the problem we have in the body of Christ that we don't put people as celebrities. Come on, somebody. And we are worshiping preachers. We are worshiping people. But we ain't worshiping God. And that's why we can't stand in the things of God. Because our trust and covenant is wise man of blessing in his garden. And the Bible said, have no confidence in the flesh. You got to be able to trust in God to know. I wish I had somebody that would be real with God. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah to God. You don't supposed to worship and worship a man. You're supposed to worship God. My God, touching his hand and God for you. I want you to understand it got nothing to do with me. It got something to do with you. The anger that I'm going to represent. My believers, come on, somebody. Hey, but I go to the same thing you go to. I'm tempted just like you are. Come on. I battle with things just like you do. I struggle with things just like you do. Y'all ain't helping me up in here today. If it had not been for the Lord that was on my side, I wouldn't be able to make it either. You better give God the brain to understand that my help is in God. The Bible said the Holy Ghost helping my infirmity. But he ain't gonna do everything for me. That's something you got to do for yourself. That's why he told you to resist the devil and he will flee. Show now to God and God shall show now to you. Touch your neighbor's neighbor. You put too much confidence in people. That's why, amen, you disappointed now. That's why you mad now. That's why you hurt right now. Because it's bad that you love a person more than you love God. Touch your neighbor's neighbor. I love you, but I love God more. And I want you to know if you backslide, I ain't about to backslide. If you throw in the towel, I ain't about to go throw in the towel. The devil is a lie. I'm still going to praise God. If you don't want to praise him, I'm going to praise him anyway. That today come my praise him. And I predicate him. What are you simply enough? You got to get to the point to understand that Jesus Christ died for your sin. And when you understand and realize, baby, who you are and who you are in God, you'll walk up in the church and don't worry about who looking at you. Don't worry about who know what you hear. But you'll enter into this gates with thanksgiving. And into his heart with praise. And you'll be thankful. And somebody say, you're blessed, Lord. I wish I had somebody. Give God the praise. Touch your neighbor's neighbor. You too wrapped up in people. And if I want people to think about you, now some people gonna always think ain't nothing to you. Now some people gonna always think you ain't living nothing. But I want you to know it ain't based on what you thinking or not, baby. Because at the end of the journey, you might not make it in. You might look around there, and I'll be pulling up the glory. Oh, God, because he already told you, accept your righteousness, I see the righteousness of the Pharisee. You can in no eyes enter the kingdom of heaven. That's your neighbor said, I see you. Coming to the church always judging me. Looking down and turning your nose up on people. Think you more holy than thou, baby. If you got that more power, won't you cast the devil out of me? If you got that more power, won't you help me get to perfection? If you got that much anointing, won't you help me get to living? I'm tired of Christian folks. Run around, jump from church. Look down on people that they ain't been able to help. That's your neighbor said, if you can't help me, then leave me alone. If you can't help me to get to perfection, I ain't got time to get nothing got to say. Because you gotta be in a place of fortuitous that whatever you see, you gotta be able to correct it. I'm tired of these hypocrites, young folks. That's why we can't win the loss. We can't leave them when they are saved. Because we too much in the way. Come on, sinner. We too much, amen. But I would know it turned out. See, you ain't got time to minister to a backslider. You ain't got time to minister to somebody that's been overtaken. You ain't got time to lift nobody up. Because you want to see them down. You want to see them fall. See, when you want to see somebody down, you ain't going to lift it up. The Bible said, if your brother is overtaken and fall, be with your spiritual. And stop touching the spirit of meekness unless you are so detailed.